Yeah, sing something, guys.
Anything.
Sing Jingle Bells.
No, sing something like you're in a 200-year-old church. Sing something for real.
Okay.
Sing of God to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul.
So we're here in a church that was founded in 1728, actually way before our nation was even founded. And this isn't the original building, but it was the original building burnt down, and this was probably built in 1870. I was way off, 50 years. But yeah, just a neat heritage group. We're playing in Montgomery, New York, and very excited to come to the Northeast. And Maine was amazing last night, Auburn, Maine, and we're looking forward to seeing what's going to happen tonight, because we know that people are hungry, and we get excited when the people are encouraged, we're encouraged, and if God's glorified, then it's amazing. So I love being in these historic churches, very sweet, I like the stained glass windows, and my wife makes it look even more beautiful. Hi.
I don't know exactly what year it was, but it was many, many years ago, and the church split was over whether to fire up the wood stove in the basement on Sunday or not. And there was a camp in the church, and this actually divided the church. There was a camp in the church that really believed that in order to, you know, by heating the furnace, that it was comfort, and we shouldn't have comfort in church.
Wow.
And so there was this big split. And so as the story goes, and this is true, confirmed in our doctrine, in our past information, right, history. So the story goes that the camp to heat the church won. And so the following Sunday, the church was going to be heated. And the people that were against it came in and complained and made big, took disrobed, you know, took off more than they would normally take off. And they were fanning themselves through the whole thing. And the guys that won never lit the stove that Sunday. So the stove was never lit, and yet these people made this big deal. It just goes to show you that, you know, I think sometimes we look nostalgically on the past,
right,
and it's not true.
No. Mm-hmm.
Sin was sin back then, it still is today, and the stupid stuff we fight over today, they fought over just the stupid stuff then. Absolutely.
So, we came up to upstate New York today, and the church here has developed this form of time travel. So literally what we're doing right now is we are going to physically go back into time about 300 years from now, and I'm going to go into a church that had just been built 300 years ago and check it out. So it's going to be interesting. This is the first time. They've done some tests on lab rats and monkeys and whatnot, but this is going to be the first time that they've actually had humans get into this contraption and go back in time. So we're going to see what happens with it. Really excited. I'm feeling pumped up. You know, just like a professional athlete, football player, baseball player, basketball player, I feel like I'm in the zone, and you know, we've been training this whole season for this, and we're going up against you know, immeasurable odds, but you know, I think we've got a really good team. I think we've really trained a lot this year, and I think we're going to be able to do really well and just knock it out and really get a win for the team and for our city.
Is this your first time traveling?
This will be my personal first time traveling. But I have gone several times back in the future in my mind, which is half the battle. You really got to get a mindset, I think, to really get in. So I've gone several other times before, you know, with the clothes I've worn, going back in time that way, with the haircuts I've gotten, going back in time that way, reverted back to a childlike state. So we're really gonna knock it out and see what happens.